Are you curious about how AI will transform your daily work or your organization? Or and you're wondering if you can create AI applications yourself or what technical skills might be required to do this? Or perhaps you're even questioning if AI can perform your current tasks. Now, to explore these intriguing questions, we've arranged an exclusive interview with two renowned AI experts. Please join me in welcoming Vicky Bunyard. She's the CTO for IBM Technology for Northern, Central and Eastern Europe. And Sophie Kuijt, she's Distinguished Engineer and CTO for IBM Consulting in Northern, Central and Eastern Europe. Welcome.
Thank you, Ronald. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to have you. Thanks for having you. So, as we see an increasing number of AI applications entering in the markets on a daily basis, it seems that the process of becoming much more accessible for everybody. Now, Sophie, in your role, can you guide organizations in implementing AI solutions? You help them with step by step. Do you believe that AI implementation is now within reach for everybody?
Yeah, it's an interesting question. I think yes, indeed. It's since the launch of Gen AI now in the minds and in hearts of many more people. Not only the IT people who were already aware of many AI capabilities, but now also it's your son or your daughter at home. It is also on board level. It's everywhere in the organizations, also the ones where we're working with. So AI is definitely there. It's really ready for business, I would say.
It's ready for everybody.
And for everybody. So it is for every domain, right? It's not only for enterprises. It's also for doctors, for lawyers, for the government. You see it really in every domain. It can be an augmentation to the humans who are involved in processes. And this makes it a very special technology.
Yeah, humans and data, which is the foundation for AI. And Vicky, given your focus on the technical aspects of AI, could you provide some current examples that really showcase what's technically possible with AI today?
Yeah, and I think, you know, there's so much that's possible out there right now, but we're also seeing a rise in things like talent management and HR applications. And we're also seeing a rise in supporting automatic generation of code, for example. So, you know, one of the key things with generative AI is it's creative, and of course it's machine-based. So creating new code with AI becomes a really interesting use case that we're seeing being picked up more and more and more. So huge range of possibilities, huge range of applications. And I think it's a little bit more, you know, we're more limited by our imagination than anything else at the moment, I think.
Yeah, definitely. And you both mentioned generative AI already. There's a lot of discussion around generative AI and its potential to automate, for some people think even entire job roles. Now, Sophie, if you look at it, what's your view on the current state of generative AI, but also the future trajectory of AI in terms of job impact? How can businesses prepare for these type of changes?
Yes, so I think it's really the time now for everybody and also, for example, ourselves, right? If you're working as a CTO or as an architect, it's really the time to think about how can this technology augment my own job role. And Vicky mentioned already something like code generation, which is really in the whole application modernization part now, an example where we are looking at from the IT industry part, generating not only code, but also, for example, automating test scripts or generating documentation, which was before could be cumbersome or something you would delay a bit further. And it can now be really be augmented by this technology. So I think, as I say, for every job, it's also for every job role that you should think about it. How can what tasks can be further automated? What can I use? And that is also how we help organizations, indeed with that imaginations about how it can help in their processes, how it can be an improvement, or it can be something to scale up or to speed up processes. I think that is really the phase where we are now. And of course you have to do that in a proper way, and we have methods and approaches for that, but it's very much about generating those innovative ideas, very much in the domain specific, so with the domain knowledge of your own industry.
Yeah, you mentioned already it can be basically used for any organization. You mentioned for any department. Now, Vicky, regarding the use and implementation of AI, if we look to skills, what specific skills are necessary? Is it a deep technical background that you need, or are there specific pathways for non-technical professionals, doctors, lawyers, etc., to effectively utilize AI in their roles?
So I think there are kind of two dimensions to this. And part of it is, if you look historically, in order to really be doing something of value with AI, you needed your deep technical experts. And we saw this, you know, the kind of rise of the data scientist, and where organizations were building up their data science teams, and you really needed those deep skills to be able to do anything with the AI. Now, okay, for certain dimensions of AI, that's still true. Yeah. So there are, you know, if you're really trying to do deep technical analysis, you still need those deep technical experts. But I think the iteration that we're going through now that becomes really interesting is we understand better how to build the tooling and build the capabilities that allow less deep technical users to still be able to take advantage of the capabilities. And I think, you know, this is the same as it ever was in history. So as we learn more about the right way to implement this, we get better at designing the tools that make it easier for people to implement these things. So the kind of two dimensions of this are, it is becoming easier and easier as, you know, a business user to be able to access tooling that gives you the capability to build your AI capability from a business perspective. And that's where Sophie's point about, you know, domain expertise and industry expertise is really powerful, because what you want to be able to do is to build your AI capability so that it supports your industry, supports your business, supports your organization. And then I think the other dimension of this is, and as we build these things, so for example, the virtual assistants that are coming through, they're specifically designed to be used by people who don't have those deep skills. And that's kind of the point of these assistants, is that you're accessing the front end of something which is much, much bigger and is technically complex in a way that's very simple on the front end. And so I think that's another major step forward that we're seeing coming through right now, is the technology organizations getting better at giving you front ends that you can do something effective with, even if you're not a deep technical expert.
Yes, and if you look to the prompting, that makes it even more easier to use it. It's not developing, but you can create your own AI answers as well.
Yeah, exactly. And I think what will be interesting going forward is focus, actually, because, you know, in this picture, you can do all kinds of things in all kinds of ways. But I think what will be really important going forward is focusing on what are you really trying to do, and who are the end users, and who, you know, what is the desired outcome of this thing?
And focusing on, yeah, what problem do you solve? I think that's the key, because there's hundreds of opportunities, maybe even thousands of opportunities, which you can solve. But it's, yeah, the key part where you need to start at and where you get your ROI and your results. Thank you, Sophie, Vicky. Great insights. Thanks for the clarification for these key questions that people have. And for the audience, thank you for watching, and looking forward to seeing you next time.